everybody, Chris from American Radon, and today we just finished an install. So today we want to go over a couple more things that we've had questions about in the past and some things we haven't necessarily covered in our videos before. So first, we're going to kind of go over pressure field extension. Second, energy efficiency. Third, we're also going to go, third and fourth, we're going to go into the attic and onto the roof. I spent some time on there today, so it explains why I need another shirt that I don't have with me today. So anyway, what I'm going to go ahead and do first is that, explain first, is that we have our main suction point and only suction point in this house today. So initially we started out with a 10-gallon pit. The reason why we decided to go with a larger pit, we actually went with 25 gallons. So when I say a pit, we actually extracted initially 10 gallons of soil out from underneath the slab. We actually decided to go with taking an additional 15 gallons on top of that 10 for a total of 25. Gallons removed. And the main reason is if we would have only stuck with that 10 gallon pit, we would have needed a larger fan, which actually equates to more money and more noise inside of your house. So, you know, nobody wants more noise than when they're trying to sleep. And honestly, there's some people like white noise. No, it's not white noise. That's a fan. And you don't want a bigger fan if you can avoid it. So, and the other part of it too, is the money. The money side might be more important for some people than sleep. For me, I need my sleep. But anyway, so moving on, the point is that the larger fan was going to cost about $150 a year to operate, and that includes conditioned air loss in the house, and then also just the cost of electricity for running the fan. Being able to use a Fantech RN2 EC, we were actually able to dial down the amount of airflow that we needed, which also allowed less noise and a cheaper annual cost. So right now we're actually at $23 a year. So just crunching the numbers super, you know, loosely, we're looking about 1/6 the cost just by a proper fan choice. And going on from there, I mean, sure, it was a little bit more work for us to dig a 25 gallon pit, but that's why we're gonna be a little bit more expensive and we will actually be able to make, you know, we may cost a little bit more up front, but in the long run, we will actually be saving you money because we're taking the extra time on the job to make sure it's done right, done correctly, and it's going to do the best for you and your family in the future. So what I want to go over next actually is going to show you our gauge that we use for measuring the pressure field extension. And it also tells us how strong it is. So we're going to take you back here. So this is our manometer, the gauge I was just mentioning. So what we got going on here, let me turn on the lights so we can see a little bit better. So we got going on here, this plugs straight into the slab. We actually go all the way down into the soil. So if we want to go ahead and pull that out, you can actually see it's just a hole in your basement. And before you ask, because this has also been of concern to people before, we don't just leave holes in your basement. We drill these, we will fill them in when we're finished with the job. So what this does though is this hole and this manometer is actually showing us that we have very good suction, very good vacuum underneath of the slab. And the main reason why, so normally we're aiming for about -5 pascals on there. And for that, and the reason why we're a little bit higher is because when you turn on all the fans in your house, your range fan to, you know, suck out all the air while you're cooking, stuff like that, or the smoke, not the air. You need air to breathe. Don't suck the air out of your house. That's a bad idea. So what this allows us to do is it gives us a bit of a buffer. So once all these turned on, it's called a test that we do. It's called max depressurization, or max D. And this actually, once we turn on all the fans in the house, takes it down to about -6. And in the winter time, it's just going to generally be a little bit lower anyway. So it gives us enough of a buffer to make sure that we're doing the job correctly and we're taking care of everything. That way you don't end up with radon intrusion later on in the year when we're not here to measure. But again, that's why we're a little bit more expensive, is because we run these diagnostics and make sure that your system is going to work properly year round. So if you want to go ahead and follow me upstairs, or actually, let's go back around the corner first. So what I will do is actually show you. This is where, so I mentioned the suction point already, and then this suction point runs up, and then right here we actually run through a closet in the main level. So from underneath, you know, just looks like a hole in the floor, but we'll kind of go up and talk a little bit more about that. But before we do that, right now, we will actually kind of talk about the ceiling that we did down here as well. So the sealant that we've got going on, really, a lot of people look at a crack and they're like, that's not a big deal. Even something as small as a dime, the width of a dime or smaller. So just if you're holding a dime on edge and looking at it, that is enough of a crack to actually be pulling air from the inside of your house. So again, when we're talking about energy efficiency, we're making sure that we're not just sucking conditioned air through your basement floor and then out through your roof. So that's also kind of a way that we save you on money. This house right now, we're only pulling about 1 CFM, 1 cubic foot per minute of conditioned air out of the house, which is excellent. And this is actually one of the, I want to say this is probably the most efficient install that I've done since I've been working with American Radon. So let's go ahead and go upstairs and we'll show you where we punch through the closet. Alright, so we're going to start down a little bit lower, and this is kind of more what we do on this job. We get into really tight places. So down here, this is right where we just showed you, or from the basement side, this is where I had showed you that we were exiting. All we do is come up from this interior closet, and we go all the way up into the attic right here. So that is where I spent some of my time this morning, and again, it was a little toasty. So we try to do the attics in the morning if we can, you know, help it. So if you want to follow me over that way, I'm gonna show you guys where I spent some of my time this morning and how we actually, we're not going to take you all the way in because nobody wants to go all the way in. So this is where you get a little, like my last video, nimble like an elephant. If you want to just go ahead and pass me the camera, it might be a little bit easier. Ladies and gentlemen, sorry for just blinding you up there. And we're going to get a little bouncy here for a second. So anyway, all the way over in that corner, you can see our fan with the insulation wrapped around it. And that box on the side is what contains a potentiometer. And that's what allows us to dial it down. You'll actually notice, and I'm actually running out of breath because it's super hot up here right now. But you'll notice that the insulation has been disturbed. Normally we would put it back after doing an install, but right now we're just gonna leave it as is because the electrician is coming in a couple of days and we're just gonna leave it as is so he can get to where he needs to without having to disturb it. He'll put it back and we'll be on our way. So let's go ahead and head back down. We'll go on outside and show you the roof. Oh, all right, this is where we exited the roof. So right here from the attic, this is where we went straight up. So where we were just at, where you saw the insulation, we come straight up here. And we actually, so this is where we vent all of our radon. And the main reason why we come up here, we actually have to stay a foot above the highest point on the roof. And that's just to make sure we're following code. Along with that, we also make sure we're installing the flashing and everything properly, that you're not gonna have water intrusions during the next rainstorm. So we're very, very careful on how we do all of that. We also put a critter guard on the top just to make sure that we're not gonna be getting any kind of leaves, sticks, actual critters that decide to go in there. And no, we're not kidding. The squirrels do like to cram their way into fan pipes on their way out. Squirrels, any kind of bug or critter who's curious and likes to get into small spaces. And nobody wants a squirrel in their fan because, yeah, we have to come back out. So we figure we might as well just go ahead and prevent that at the source by just putting a little grate over the top. And then also too, while we're up here, we also make sure to paint the pipe, or paint our exhaust pipe, just to make sure that we're kind of blending into your roof, not just leaving a giant white pipe sticking out on your roof. Because again, we're trying to do this the best way possible, make it look as nice as possible, rather than just doing it, you know, how, you know, somebody who consider like a fly by night installer just come out and throw things together and not necessarily take the time or effort to do it the right way and make it look nice. So if you guys have any questions, comments, or concerns, feel free to leave a comment, give this video a like, hit the subscribe button, and you will always be alerted to whenever we put up one of our super high production value videos. So anyway, my name is Chris with American Radon. Thanks so much for watching. Have a great day.